most of us are rookies. How many of you had video learned Gospel training in residency? Okay, just the young faces in the crowd. So the rest of us, we're basically picking this up new. And the analogy I use is, how many of you were doing IJs before there was ultrasound? So not many of us left. So then ultrasound came, and it was like, oh, wow, there's this new way of doing it. But, like, I was retarded the first few times I'm doing it. I'm, like, trying to slide the probe around and see, and it was, you know. But now it's the state of the art, and we're all fast at it. I think eventually the state of the art in emergency medicine will be video laryngoscopy for all patients, and that direct laryngoscopy is going to be an important skill when there's blood, pus, or vomit, but that, you know, that most patients are going to be intubated with video. I think that's where we're heading, just as now essentially all IJs are done with ultrasound guidance. So the biggest thing is positioning. And so I've had some partners that try the video laryngoscope, and they put that thing in right into the vallecula, and they get this fantastic view here, but it's actually closer, and all they can see is cords. The whole screen is cords, and they never see the ET tube come in. It's completely invisible, and they throw the thing away, grab the regular laryngoscope, and intubate. And so the key here is that it's totally different where you're putting the tip. So if you're doing direct laryngoscopy, the tip of your blade is going in the vallecum. But if you're doing video laryngoscopy, you essentially just want to get to the base of the tongue, just around the bottom of the tongue, and what you want is this long tunnel view of the cords. You don't want the cords right up in your face, because otherwise you're not going to be able to see your ET tube and be able to place it. So again, the same technique in terms of passing it. I use a bougie. So I use a bougie for all video laryngoscopy, and I'm a rookie. I wasn't trained in it. So what I do is I find it's easier to pass this than either the GlideScope stylet or a regular ET tube. And what I do is I put a little extra bend in this. So the bougie has a little bit of memory. So basically, this is how I set my bougie up, like this. And so I got my view, and I find it very easy to snake this thing into the cords and then load the endotracheal tube over the top of that. So that's just what I found that helps me be more like an expert. So one thing about the GlideScope stylet that I want to mention is GlideScope stylet is never supposed to enter the cords. So unlike what we're used to with a normal stylet, we put the stylet through the cords and then we pull it out. But the GlideScope stylet is never supposed to go through the cords. And there's been actually a significant number of tracheal perforations when it's actually placed through and it causes a tear in the trachea. It's designed to go right to the edge of the cords, and then you flick it with your thumb, and then it kicks off, and then you pass it, and the stylet comes off of it. And so for those of us who are rookies that weren't formally trained by the GlideScope reps or whoever, we assume it's like any other stylet. It's just, well, it's weird, it's shaped like a question mark, and we put that thing through, but that can cause some damage. And there's also been some cases where it tears off the tonsillar pillars. It actually basically comes through and damages the tonsillar pillars. So just be aware of that if you like the GlideScope stylet. Okay, so what about blood, pus, and vomit? So one technique that I was told about but I haven't tried is to take the Yankauer and tape it to the blade of your laryngoscope. So you're kind of like, you're like a submarine in there, like suctioning out the Bud Light, looking for the targets. So that's one option. But one of the things that I think many of us wring our hands about is, if these new residents coming out don't have good DL skills, how are they going to manage these kinds of airways? And so I don't think that video laryngoscopy is ever going to replace direct laryngoscopy, because blood, pus, and vomit is always going to be a problem. So, you know, we're going to need to have both skills. For most of us, we need to learn the video. But I think for the newer residents, you know, I'm worried about how much DL they're getting. What's your experience in terms of that?
So if there's a lot of blood or vomit, uh-huh. Anesthesia hates this, but I actually just goose the patient. That uh-huh. way I can connect that ET tube to the suction directly. Uh-huh. And then now I know exactly where the other hole is, so I can look for it.
So that's a great point. I'm glad he brought that up. So what if you get the ET tube in the esophagus? Well, our reflex has always been like, oh my God, and we pull it out. But leave the ET tube in the esophagus. Now there's only one hole left. I mean, sometimes I'll just take the bougie and just blindly sound for it now that there's only one hole left, or try to follow the bubbles. So if you get it in the, and hooking it suction is clever. I hadn't thought of that, but yeah. That's a great way to clear that out. So yeah, if you end up in the esophagus, just leave it there and keep working. Okay, so quick review of the algorithm, then we'll take a break. So where do we make mistakes? We don't evaluate the airway. We don't predict if they're gonna be difficult or not difficult, and we certainly don't document that well. The next mistake we make is we try more than three attempts at laryngoscopy. And finally, the last mistake is that we don't go to the surgical airway. Wrap up the first part of RSI. Positioning is really important. Oxygen two ways, and here's a picture of one of those double trees that goes into a single wall mount. In terms of drugs, rocuronium is the drug of choice because it has longer paralysis and no side effects. And finally, epiglottoscopy, thinking of looking for the epiglottis versus looking for the cords, using the epiglottis as a landmark to get you to the final destination.